Today we're going to show you a great gravel ride from Birdlings Flat, and it's just started raining. New Zealand has over 30,000 kilometres of gravel roads. Today we're going to take you on a ride on the Banks Peninsula near Christchurch.
We're riding a return trip on the Bossu road. This will take us along the southern part of the Banks Peninsula. The Banks Peninsula is just a big extinct volcano, and the area's got very few residents. There's hardly any shops and services outside of the main town of Akaroa, so you should definitely bring everything you plan to eat or drink with you.
The ride starts cutting across this gravel beach. Before long you get to this tiny little bridge, relatively new, and you're into the first climb of the day. This is the first climb, and it's lined with spectators.
The first climb takes you over 700 metres from sea level in around 11 kilometres. It's a decent climb, but it's achievable for anyone with decent bike fitness.
As soon as you start to gain altitude, the views open up, and the rest of the ride is great the whole way.
During the ride, you'll see lots of little roads off to the left and right that look pretty appealing. Every single one of these is another little adventure you can go on. Tons of little secluded bays, surf beaches, some of them just take you back to the main roads. Well worth a look. There's weeks worth of exploring out here. A quick look on Bookabatch or one of the other accommodation sites will let you find hundreds of little places to stay, mostly privately owned.
We're at one of the junctions you get to here that you need to get right. Go the wrong way and you'll drop into a bay. Lovely descent, but you'll notice the climb on the way back up. That's the way to go. We're at one of the high points on the ride. Clouds just coming in. I wish you could see the view, but I guess you'll have to come and ride it yourself if you want to see that. This is one of the first sections of smooth gravel for the day.
I should mention that some of the gravel on this ride is pretty chunky. In fact, probably pretty dangerous for your tyres, but more on that later.
Feels good.
The plan for this ride is to go from Birdlings Flat to Land's End Road and back again. Like I said before, there's tons of different routes you can take, and we're just about to come up on one of these little crossroads now.
That looks massive.
Yeah, this climb looks like a bit of a wall. You get the option, you can go left and head down Jubilee Road, or you can do what we're doing and continue on. A nice view across to Akaroa. And we've only really got one big climb left that I know about. Probably five. Here we are, one of the high points on the road. It's about 760 metres according to looking at a map and guessing.
So check these views, awesome. We're just about to get to one of the best descents of the day.
It's puncture time. Although, it's not the most horrible location to have a puncture, is it?
Luckily enough, we've got two spare tubes, so it shouldn't take too long. Puncture's fixed and we decide probably not a good idea to ride this descent and back up, because otherwise I'm going to be late for putting my kids to bed. And it's lucky that that's what we did, because here's another puncture.
It's another lovely spot for a puncture. And this time I've run out of tubes, so I have to fix a tube. Perfect. time to go though.
This descent probably gives you a pretty good idea of what kind of redding there is available up here. Obviously, the faster you go, the more of the road you get to see in the shortest time. I've added a bit of a bonus descent at the end of the video, and I guarantee I get a 50 plus kph puncture in the front tyre at some point. I'll leave you to watch a bit of gravel descending.
This time it's a front. Fuck. Oh well.
You know how I said we had two tubes? Well, guess what? Puncture number three.
I guess I'll change it at the bottom. And then take it nice and easy.
Sorry.
Alright. Oh, you're fucking kidding.
After I'd fixed this next puncture, and that was by borrowing a spare tube from my friend Dave, I decided that it would be a pretty decent idea for me to take it a bit more cautiously so that we don't end up having to walk a few k's back to the car. Take a look at this descent and some of these views. Of course, towards the end of the descent, I realised that I could ride the rest of the way to the car with two flat tyres if I had to, so I just sort of ignored my own advice and rode down the hill like normal. One thing that you might notice is the lines I take around the corners. Because of the washboarding that happens to the road from four-wheel drives, it's often a good idea to try and avoid the inside of the corners because it's really rough. If you manage to position yourself on the outside of the corners, or the outside wheel track, you get a mostly swept gravel area that isn't too rough. And I recommend doing that if you want to keep your hands feeling good. Enjoy, see y'all later. Oh yeah, if you like this video or you want me to make more videos about the Banks Peninsula, which I'm probably going to do anyway, comment below or hit the like button, hit the bell, subscribe, do all that YouTube stuff. Thanks guys!
Yeah.